Hey tennis fans, I'm Grace Carter and this is Tennis Now. Rafa Nadal could be a Spanish leader this summer because it seems the president of the Spanish Olympic Committee would like Nadal to be the nation's flag bearer at the Rio Olympic Games. He says Rafa has done a lot for Spanish sports. Alejandro Blanco says that Spanish sports owes a lot to Rafa because he has taken Spanish sports to a whole nother level. And he says that after the way Rafa's been treated regarding drug allegations, Rafa deserves to feel that Spanish sports cares about him. You may recall the King of Clay was selected as Spain's flag bearer for the 2012 London Games. However, he suffered a knee injury which sidelined him for the final 7 months of that season. Earlier this month, a former French Secretary of Sport said that Nadal's break from tennis in 2012 was, without a doubt, because he tested positive. Rafa has vowed to sue her and anyone else who makes unfounded doping allegations against him. Back in 2008, Rafa defeated Fernando Gonzalez to win the gold medal at the Beijing Olympics. Roger Federer is looking forward to the Rio Games, which will be his fifth Olympics. Roger hasn't played since undergoing knee surgery after the Australian Open. Federer, who loves to travel, says this will be his first time in Rio and he is very excited about it. He says Olympic Games are massively important to him. He loves playing in the Olympics and loves representing Switzerland. Roger won the singles silver medal at the 2012 Games, but has yet to win a gold medal in singles. Fed partnered with his good buddy Stan Wawrinka, they captured the doubles gold at the 2008 Beijing Games, giving us one of the greatest Olympic tennis celebrations, and they showed their deep bond. Very fun to watch. The Olympic Games hold a special place in Roger's heart for a whole nother reason. He met his wife, Mirka, at the 2000 Sydney Olympics when he was just 19 years old, and it happens to be where the couple had their very first kiss, and that's very sweet. In Rio, Roger's going to partner with Martina Hingis in mixed doubles and could join forces with Stan again in doubles, but that hasn't yet been finalized. Okay, here's a question for you. Do you think you'll see Maria Sharapova in Rio? Well, one Russian official believes it will happen. Russian Tennis Federation President Shamil Tarpachev says Maria's hearing for her Australian Open doping violation could be put off until June. Tarpachev says he thinks the scandal is a load of nonsense and said that he thinks Sharapova will play at the Olympics. However, he does admit he has to wait to see how it's all going to develop. Maria's lawyer, meantime, John Haggerty, is expected to provide records to support his argument that the five-time Grand Slam champion has taken meldonium for medical reasons for the past decade. At the Brisbane International in January, Maria told guest interviewer Roger Federer that undergoing surgery in 2008, which forced her out of the game for a while, provided a sense of perspective for her.
That tennis was pretty much all I thought about, all I knew, all I really had a passion for, and then you realize that that's not all your life.
This week, Maria received support from a Hall of Famer and a stinging criticism from a New York City newspaper. Former number one, Jimmy Connors, who coached Maria for all of one match before their split, told TMZ that he hopes she'll be allowed to play again.
You know, whatever it takes to be good, you got to do that. So
okay.
That's the team. I hope she has an opportunity to come back and to play.
Right.
And to be as good as she is,
right.
And she should be, and to give her that opportunity to play.
Connor's support came a day before the New York Post slammed Sharapova with this report. The tabloid quotes a coach of a former top 10 player who calls Maria very cold and suggests that players stop talking when she walks in the lounge and asserts that she even put a gag order on her former boyfriend, Grigor Dimitrov. He goes on to say she most definitely doesn't seem to have any friends on tour. She's very cold. When Maria walks into the players' lounge, things will stop mid-sentence. Her camp, which includes coaches, trainers, and assistants, and even her ex-boyfriend, Grigor Dimitrov, would be chatting with everybody, and then Sharapova would walk in, and Grigor and her coach would make eye contact and know to stop socializing. That report also claims that Maria and Victoria Azarenka cannot stand one another. Okay, as for Victoria Azarenka, she scored her 11th straight win, surging into the Miami Open semifinals. Vika is bidding to join Steffi Graf and Kim Clijsters as the third woman in history to complete the rare coast-to-coast Indian Wells and Miami title sweep in the same season. The two-time Miami champion told CNN's Open Court that putting in hard yards on the sand helped prepare her for this hard court season. Vika says fitness training has revolutionized the women's game. That's the news for now, everybody. I'm Grace Carter. See you next time here on Tennis Now.